Hello guys, let's review another game. That's much better. The name calls Do You Know Jack? It's 1999's game. It's pretty old. It's not that old compared to other games. Right. It's a puzzle game.
60 seconds. Okay, could someone check out Scooby's Lavalier?
Right on.
Thank you.
Re-bop, re-bop. Scooby-up, Scooby-up.
Don't make me come out of this booth.
Okay, before we can get started, we have to do a little head count.
No, more interest.
Can we get a spot?
Great. I'm going to walk you through everything. Look, tell me how many people are playing, and then we'll work on getting you off that nipple. The 7-question tournament life game or the big 21-question kahuna?
I didn't realize he's talking about it.
If you're going to be this indecisive, I'm just going to throw you in for a full game, all right? Okay. You're going to get a bunch of questions. First person to hit their buzzer gets first crack at the catch. Pick the answer you think is right and hit the button on the controller. Easier than putting on loafers. Okay, so these buttons in the front will be your buzzers, and these four will be where you pick the answer. Simple as pie, however simple pie happens.
Really much so. The background noise?
10 seconds.
Let's go to black.
9.
All right, 8.
All right,
see on the other side.
Go, bring in the logo.
6. 5. 4.
Didn't really realize
this
guy is stuck in the
middle. Also available, My Little Split Personality and My Little Addiction.
What's going on now? All right, this time we know. I think we officially started. Because the angel was crazy. I didn't realize he talking but no. It was fun. It was very original. Do you know Jack?
One of you is gonna lose.
Shows game.
Okay, let's get
something
started. And of course, no game is fun without sharp objects to play with. Here's the deal with these screws. If you think your neighbor's clueless, you buzz it and you select to screw them. You buzz it and you hit your select button. And they've got to answer it. All right, let's do it. Player one, give me category.
All right, I don't really know what's going on now. I'm trying to figure it out.
Let's finish the game sometime this week.
Yeah, sure. No, it's in the first. It's not really.
Now
clear.
Serving. Another reason CDs are better than vinyl. Get it right. I'm handing over 2K. Okay, you know what I hated about records? They got all scratched and broken after a while. If you've got an LP that's broke, it's probably from overuse. But if you have an album that's baroque, which of the following composers are most likely responsible? Bach, Bernstein, Beethoven, or Brahms? Hey, shortcut! Buzz in first! Please hit your buzzer! Here's what you should have picked.
Bitch.
The person responsible for the most popular Baroque music is Johann Sebastian Bach. Today's music is crap!
Mr. Bach, I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
Well.
Your pick, player two, how about it? Hey, that slow and steady wins the race crap doesn't fly around here.
You know,
the selection
really
is,
like,
it's not music, it's just noise.
Because
that is $2,000 sound. Just step up
games.
And take a swing at this one. If you apply the pH scale to your radio, what type of music would send it to zero? Heavy metal, acid rock, light jazz, or deep house?
don't have it there. If you apply it to pH scale to your radio. pH scale? Maybe in America or something.
The correct answer is, the pH scale measures acidity, so acid rock would rate as zero, or strongly acid.
I don't care what it rates. It's all just noise anyway.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Player one, your choice. What are we doing?
All right, another question.
Shake hands with sex, drugs, and British law. $2,000 for a correct answer. Put it in
all
gear,
right.
Cause here
and
we go. If musicians had had to adhere to the Magna Carta, what might rock fans have seen? King Crimson consulting with Parliament, the cars moving to opposite side of the street, Queen deporting foreign-born Freddie Mercury, or Prince relinquishing interest in America?
If musicians had to adhere to Magna I just pressed random button.
Hey, genius! I said buzz in! See, now, I could have given you some cash if you pick this. Since the Magna Carta made the King of England consult Parliament before passing laws and raising taxes, it could have also made King Crimson consult George Clinton's funk band Parliament before deciding on which knee-high boots and cape to wear on tour.
All right.
Player one, it's up to you. What's next?
You gotta head for, yeah.
This one likes to go by, people who read people are the luckiest people. And we got $3,000 in the pot. Ah, the
okay,
80s. What the hell were we thinking? According to People magazine, who is the sexiest man alive in 1986?
Right.
John F. Kennedy Jr., Mark Harmon, Harry Hamlin, or Patrick Swayze? Buzz in first. What are you, high? Buzz in! No, you gotta buzz in!
Oh, I can't touch it because I have to, like, a weird layer choice.
Ooh, the writing's on the wall.
I cannot
right
control
next to
other
my poster
player.
Of that dreamy hunk, Mark Harmon. Yeah, you heard me. Sexiest man on the face of the earth, Mr. Mark Harmon. Hey, don't laugh. Back in the 80s, everybody looked good.
Cool.
Category time. Player two, call. This little number's known as the great Latin lover, Tom Selleck. $2,000 says you don't know this one. Let's see if you can wrap your head around this. If you were to ask Magnum P.I. about his magnum opus, about what would he most likely tell you? His favorite handgun, his evil twin IP Mungam, his greatest case, or his pet penguin? Buzz in, buzz in! Okay,
no,
I'm
not controlling the player. So,
can you beat me? Hit your buzzer, you can do it! Bet you wish you'd pick this. Magnum opus translates to great work, so Magnum would be telling you about his greatest case. Although on some episodes, the mustache is the best thing going.
Yeah, James Bond.
Player one, hit me with the category.
Alright, is it a boss or something? Yeah, it is. So, I have a design about this game. Yeah, it is fun. It really is fun, but you have to, like, beat that, you know, the show anyways, and you know that show's type and those questions type, because it's not just a straight question and straight answers, and you, those answers you really have to know. But this game is really fun, and I have to tell you, can you play in this 2020? Yeah, you definitely can, because those games, I think it is never old, and I think you have lots of fun playing this game with your friend, and maybe if you're playing just for yourself, yeah, I said, give it a go, let's try it and play. Okay, let's. Yeah. It's like a cool music. Cool.
Is it all the big
atmosphere.
Words that are slowing you down?
Entertaining. I really, it's fun.
The category is, you won't need a number two pencil, and it's worth $2,000 if you get this one right. Heads up, here
and
it comes.
And if you get like if Charlie money, real money, class, really, really
were to give all
awesome.
Of his students the Wasserman test, what could he determine from the results? Eric does not have rabies, Dennis's emotional growth has been minimal, Darlene has a genius level IQ, or Arvid does not have syphilis.
I don't know what else you have to know, but we
no,
don't have an idea.
Do you know? Alright.
If you like, you
for the curious,
game, you,
here's
you
the right
like,
answer. It's one test the kids
can,
really shouldn't cram for. The
you,
Wasserman test is a test for syphilis.
Game?
So
really
now there's out, no way anyone will believe our
comment.
Stories about the girl he met on summer vacation.
Really interesting if you can
player
play
two,
this
something.
Game. Because those questions, it really is tricky. And it was a big challenge. Alright.
It's only a game. Just pick one.
Seven. Lucky seven.
For all
here we have
numbers,
Baby's Got Wayback Machine. I'm
brilliant.
Giving out $3,000 for a right answer. Oh dear, it seems Mr. Peabody and his pet boy Sherman have gone into a defective Wayback Machine and don't know where they are. Say, Mr. Peabody asks someone what time it is and gets the famous quote, these are the times that try men's souls. In what time period have Mr. Peabody and Sherman emerged? Medieval times, the Great Depression, the French Revolution, or the American Revolution?
Yes, do you have an answer?
No, I need a buzzer!
You have to defend in
no,
10 seconds,
I
but I can't impress because we played 2. I have to play it at 1.
In case you're wondering, Patriot Thomas Paine wrote these words as a
yeah,
soldier in the
fun.
Revolutionary
like
Army, so Sherman better grab
a
musket while Mr. Peabody just goes after some redcoat's crotch.
And the cool music, cool entertainment,
let's have a
category for your showman or something. It's cool, yeah. So, I'm pause a little bit because it's does music. And, yeah, if I have to tell you, you can definitely play this game, you can definitely try it, comment if you will, if you wanna try it, and comment how it goes. It's okay, as maybe you are smarter than me. Okay, so I'm leaving with that, and I'll see you in the next game played. See ya.